The sooner we deal with the threats to the Empress, the better. The political situation in the Empire is dangerously unstable. It will complicate matters.
Everything in the Empire complicates matters. It's the Orlesian national pastime.
Turn your nose up at the grand game if you like, Commander, but we play for the highest stakes, and to the death.
The Court's disapproval can be as great a threat as the Venatori. We must be vigilant to avert disaster.
Don't worry, Josephine. We'll protect the Empress, no matter what.
I pray you're right. If your vision of the future comes to pass, the death of the Empress heralds the destruction of everything. Orle holds Tevinter at bay. All of Tedas could be lost if the Empire falls to Corypheus. Selene is holding peace talks under the auspices of a grand masquerade. Every power in Orle will be there. It's the perfect place for an assassin to hide.
Does Selene know about the threats against her? Can we send word?
I've sent messages to the Empress, but it's impossible to know if she's received them. I'll arrange for an invitation at your discretion, Inquisitor.
Send men to scout the area. We need to know what's out there.
Yes, sir!
Commander, soldiers have been assigned temporary quarters.
Very good. I'll need an update on the armory as well. Now! We set up as best we could at Haven, but could never prepare for an archdemon, or whatever it was. With some warning, we might have...
We were all shaken by what happened.
If Corypheus strikes again, we may not be able to withdraw. And I wouldn't want to. We must be ready. Work on Skyhold is underway. Guard rotations established. We should have everything on course within the week. We will not run from here, Inquisitor.
How many were lost?
Most of our people made it to Skyhold. It could have been worse. Morale was low, but it's improved greatly since you accepted the role of Inquisitor.
Everyone has so much faith in my leadership. I hope I'm ready.
You won't have to carry the Inquisition alone, although it must feel like. We needed a leader, and you have proven yourself.
Thank you, Cullen. Our escape from Haven. It was close. I'm relieved that you, that so many made it out.
As am I. You stayed behind. You could have... I will not allow the events at Haven to happen again. You have my word. Did you need something?
Did you leave anyone behind in Kirkwall?
No. I fear I made few friends there, and my family's in Ferelden.
No one special caught your interest?
Not in Kirkwall.
Is there anything I should know?
Repairs to Skyhold's fortifications are progressing. Our scouts report no immediate threats in the surrounding area. We are fortunate Solas knew of this place.
That's all for now.
I'm sure you have other matters to attend.
So, Inquisitor. It is Inquisitor now, right? Remember that war we talked about stopping? Full of little baddies I can stick with little arrows. That's not a friggin' archdemon, is it? Draste, what do I step in?
Let me know what she says. I could use some clarification myself.
It's swearing, not praying. She doesn't answer. Not like she's supposed to. I know what happened to you, or what everyone here thinks happened. It seems... I don't know what it seems.
The ancient thing trying to kill us seems pretty real.
Don't get me started. Oh, wait, too late, right? A magister who cracked the Black City. It's a hazy dream, right? I mean, if it's real, real, then the seat of the Maker? Real thing. A seat needs a butt, so the Maker? Real thing. Fairy stories about the start and end of the world. Real things. It's too far, isn't it? I just want to plug the Skyhole rubbish so I can go play.
You joined to help the little people caught up in this. But do you believe or not?
In Andraste? Of course.
But you doubt what you're seeing and hearing?
It can't be true. Even fanatics don't want to be this right. Look, I have arrows. I can make this Corypheus believe in those. Good enough? Please be good enough.
Keep calling it nonsense. That perspective will keep the Inquisition grounded.
Oh, I can do that. Sure could use a few more people shouting no. We fight, the bad things go away, everyone calms down, and everything goes back to normal. A nice, well-paid normal.
You're starting to not sound completely crazy.
I know, scary, isn't it? So bring them on. But first, food. I'm starving.
It was a mistake to use Haven as a base of operations. The town was completely indefensible.
It was a bad location. We should have moved sooner.
You left yourself vulnerable to attack. It was a miscalculation, one that I'm sure you won't repeat. But the enemy struck a serious blow against you and the Inquisition. We must recognize that. You must.
So many people are joining this fight. What if I'm only leading them to their deaths?
Death is a part of war, my dear, and a part of life. We cannot escape it. Those who die for the Inquisition give their lives willingly. The alternative is to forfeit all they cherish to these horrors from the sky. Our enemy advances, Inquisitor. We must not sit idly by. Act first and teach them to fear us. You can become the leader the faithful require, but you must do it soon.
When you've got a second, there's something I want to show you.
What did you want me to come see?
Here, come on. I'll show you.
Why am I dressed like this?
You'll see. Come on. It'll be worth your time, I promise. Evening. Iron Bull. My merc band just joined up.
Tanner. I'm from Jader. Well, near Jader.
Mira. I was guard captain for Lady Pendel. Signed on after shit blew up at the conclave. Share a drink? Who's your friend?
This is Grim. She doesn't talk much.
It's a pleasure.
Hey, Grim. Do I know you from somewhere?
So, you ready to kill some demons? Or Venatori, or whatever that Corypheus asshole is?
This isn't just about killing. We're helping the Inquisitor save the world and build the next empire.
The Inquisitor isn't a god. She's just a woman trying to do the right thing.
Well, long as I get paid, I'm happy. That's why I signed up.
I just couldn't spend my whole life on a farm. Needed to live a little, you know.
What about you, Mira? Why'd you join up? I thought you were serving some noble.
I saw what happened at Haven. The Inquisitor staring down that monster and his archdemon. I don't sing the chant of light as much as I should, but you can't see something like that and not believe.
Well, Grim and I should find our tents. Thanks for the drink. I know every soldier under my command. You don't have that option. But a few faces might help.
You made it sound like you didn't like the Inquisition.
People don't always tell the truth when you're polite. You've got to poke them a bit.
It was good to get their perspective.
Yeah. Sounds like we could use an easy win for boys like Tanner. And vets like Mira have seen enough to be wary. You've got a good army coming along. Remember that. No matter what comes next.
So, this is Skyhold. Come, let's walk the ramparts. I want to examine our fortifications. We'll be able to see Corypheus coming from miles away.
Corypheus thinks we're beaten. By the time he finds us, we'll be legion.
I know soldiers. I know our soldiers. Corypheus made 100 enemies when he kicked down our door. Let him come. I swear I'll take the Twister bastard down, even if I have to die to do it.
I'm grateful for your support.
It's my job, isn't it? Killing Darkspawn. Look, in spite of it all, there is hope. The people flock to your banner. They believe in you. Tell me honestly, are you what they say you are? Andraste's chosen.
There's so little I remember. What if they're right?
Does it even matter? Don't you see what you are to them? Without you, they'd be consumed by despair. We all would. They need you to be Andraste's messenger. It gives them hope. The truth doesn't matter. Listen to me talk. Your time is valuable, and I've wasted enough of it.
Brilliant, isn't it? One moment you're trying to restore order in a world gone mad. That should be enough for anyone to handle, yes? Then, out of nowhere, an archdemon appears and kicks you in the head. What? You thought this would be easy? No, I was just hoping you wouldn't crush our village like an anthill. Sorry about that. Archdemons like to crush, you know. Can't be helped. Am I speaking too quickly for you?
The attack was unexpected. We're all rattled.
I'm not rattled. I'm the hero of this tale.
And then why isn't Corypheus after you?
Good point. Does that make me a lackey? That's dangerous work. I always assumed the elder one behind the Venatori was a magister. But this is something else completely. In Tevinter, they say the Chantry's tales of magisters starting the Blight are just that. Tales. But here we are. One of those very magisters, a Darkspawn.
Who does the Imperium say started the Blight?
You know how it is.
Not us.
They say Darkspawn were always there. Magisters and the Blight aren't even related. Is that a surprise? No one wants to admit they shit the bed. But if Corypheus is one of the Magisters who entered the Black City and he's Darkspawn, what other explanation is there?
Why does that make you angry?
Because the Imperium is my home. I knew what I was taught couldn't be the whole truth, but I assumed there had to be a kernel of it, somewhere. But no, it was us all along. We destroyed the world.
You didn't do anything. Those men did, 1,000 years ago.
True, except that one of them is up and walking around right now. Not to mention I have idiot countrymen who would happily follow him down that path again. No one will thank me, whatever happens. No one will thank you, either. You know that, yes?
That attitude must be why they kicked you out of the Imperium.
They didn't kick me out? Well, only because they never got around to it. Eventually, they might have. All I know is this. Corypheus needs to be stopped. Men like him ruined my homeland. I won't stand by and let him ruin the world. Oh, and congratulations on that whole leading the Inquisition thing, by the way.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
The names of those we lost. You must blame me for this.
We all saw who attacked us. We know exactly who to blame.
I keep wondering if I could have done something different. When the first of my lookouts went missing, I pulled the rest back, awaiting more information. If they'd stayed in the field, they could have bought us more time. I was afraid to lose my agents. And instead, we lost Haven.
You look out for your people. That's a good thing.
Is it? My people know their duty. They know the risks. They understand that the Inquisition may call upon them to give their lives.
Our people aren't tools to be used and discarded. Your instincts were right. Their lives matter.
Can we afford such sentimentality? What if Corypheus?
We are better than Corypheus. Why here?
Haven is familiar. It will always be important to you.
We talked about that already.
I sat beside you while you slept, studying the anchor.
I'm glad someone was watching over me.
You were a mystery. You still are. I ran every test I could imagine, searched the Fade, yet found nothing. Cassandra suspected duplicity. She threatened to have me executed as an apostate if I didn't produce results.
I would never have agreed to that.
You were in no position to argue. You were never going to wake up? How could you? A mortal sent physically through the Fade. I was frustrated, frightened. The spirits I might have consulted had been driven away by the breach. Although I wished to help, I had no faith in Cassandra, or she in me. I was ready to flee.
The breach threatened the whole world. Where did you plan to go?
Someplace far away, where I might research a way to repair the breach before its effects reached me. I never said it was a good plan. I told myself, one more attempt to seal the rifts. I tried and failed. No ordinary magic would affect them. I watched the rifts expand and grow, resigned myself to flee, and then... It seems you hold the key to our salvation. You had sealed it with a gesture. And right then, I felt the whole world change.
For all our sakes, I'm pleased that you stuck around.
As am I. You have fractured rules of man and nature, and you will shatter more before you are done. Visiting me here, even as a mage, it should not have been so easy for you.
What do you mean?
Where do you think we were?
This isn't real.
That's a matter of debate. Probably best discussed after you wake up. Sleep well?
I've never done anything like that before. Do you regularly talk to people in dreams?
No. Consider that one more rule you have effortlessly broken in your rise to power. I had no idea that the anchor would allow you to dream with such focus. It is truly remarkable, but I am reasonably certain we are awake now. And if you wish to discuss anything, I would enjoy talking.
I'd like to hear more about what you saw in your exploration of the Fade.
I would be happy to share it with you.
Tell me about the old ruins you explored.
I found the ruin of Barandur, a lost Devinter city buried deep beneath the dead and barren wasteland. Volcanic ash had sealed it tight. In one dark moment, every living creature in the city seared and smothered. They were statues in the ashes, like a mold made to recall the lost.
Tell me about a spirit you encountered.
I met a friendly spirit who observed the dreams of village girls as love first blossomed in their adolescence. With subtlety, she steered them all to village boys with gentle hearts, who would return their love with gentle kindness. The matchmaker, so I called her. That small village never knew its luck.
Tell me about the old memories you found in the Fade.
I saw a savage human horde go marching toward the battlefront. They sang a soldier's hymn to keep formation. Primal music shook the ground. These savage, unwashed warriors carried harmonies no chantry choir has mastered. Though their cause was all but hopeless, they sang songs that made the spirits weep.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Inquisitor?
The Arcanist has arrived?
You should see for yourself.
Hello there.
Impressive, is it not? Fit for a leader, meant to show influence and the burden of it. It is where the Inquisition will sit in judgment, where you will sit in judgment.
Who will I be judging, exactly?
Those who have done wrong. You will know of them, at the very least. All this presumes they have survived their initial encounter with you, of course.
Still more lives in my hands.
You are a beacon of law, Inquisitor, as others retreat from responsibility. But this needn't be bloody. The Inquisition's sovereignty is derived from the allies who validate it. You are both empowered and bound. Justice has many tools. If their application is clever, execution may even seem merciful by comparison.
Is there anyone I should judge?
Take the throne when you're ready. We will bring him before you. You recall Geryon Alexius of De Winter. Ferelden has given him to us as an acknowledgement of your aid. The formal charges are apostasy, attempted enslavement, and attempted assassination, on your own life, no less. De Winter has disowned and stripped him of his rank. You may judge the former Magister as you see fit.
And I remember what would have happened to Thedas if his treachery had succeeded.
I couldn't save my son. Do you think my fate matters to me?
Will you offer nothing more in your defense?
You've won nothing. The people you saved, the acclaim you've gathered. You'll lose it all in the storm to come.
Render your judgment, Inquisitor.
You swore to the mages you'd help them. I will have you uphold that promise. Fiona will take charge of you. Any knowledge, favor, or coin you own will go towards the mage's future.
A headsman would have been kinder.
This thing is not a stray puppy you can make into a pet. It has no business being here.
Wouldn't you say the same of an apostate?
Inquisitor. I wondered if Cole was perhaps a mage, given his unusual abilities.
He can cause people to forget him, or even fail entirely to notice him. These are not the abilities of a mage. It seems that Cole is a spirit.
It is a demon.
If you prefer, although the truth is somewhat more complex.
Cole warned us about Corypheus at Haven. He saved a lot of lives.
And what will its help cost? How many lives will this demon later claim?
In fact, his nature is not so easily defined.
Speak plainly, Solas. What are we dealing with?
Demons normally enter this world by possessing something. In their true form, they look bizarre, monstrous.
But you claim Cole looks like a young man. Is it possession?
No. He has possessed nothing and no one. And yet he appears human in all respects. Cole is unique, Inquisitor. More than that, he wishes to help. I suggest you allow him to do so.
In my studies, demons either possessed something from this world, or were summoned and bound. They almost never look like something you'd mistake for a person.
Normally you'd be correct. but Cole has willfully manifested in human form without possessing anyone.
The demons who came through the breach, or through the rifts, weren't possessing anything.
These demons were drawn through against their will, driven mad by this world. But Cole predates the breach. From what we can tell, he has lived here for months, perhaps years. He looks like a young man. For all intents and purposes, he is a young man. It is remarkable.
I should hear what Cole has to say for himself. Where is he now?
If none of us remember him, he could be anywhere.
Haven. So many soldiers fought to protect the pilgrims so they could escape. Choking fear. Can't think from the medicine, but the cuts rack me with every heartbeat. Hot, white pain. Everything burns. I can't. I'm dying. I'm...
dead.
You're feeling their pain?
It's louder this close, with so many of them.
Would you like to go somewhere more comfortable?
Yes, but here is where I can help. Every breath slower, like lying in a warm bath, sliding away. Smell of my daughter's hair when I kiss her goodnight.
Gone.
Cracked brown pain, dry, scraping, thirsty. Here.
Thank you.
It's all right. She won't remember me.
You're using your powers as a spirit to help people.
Yes. I used to think I was a ghost. I didn't know. I made mistakes, but I made friends, too. Then a Templar proved I wasn't real. I lost my friends. I lost everything. I learned how to be more like what I am. It made me different, but stronger. I can feel more. I can help.
If you're willing, the Inquisition could use your help.
Yes, helping. I help the hurt, the helpless. There's someone. Hurts. It hurts. It hurts. Someone make it stop hurting. Make her, please. The healers have done all they can. It will take him hours to die. Every moment will be agony. He wants mercy. Help.
All right. Help him.
It's all right. I want to stay.
Good book?
Oh, I don't know what you're talking about.
Wait, are you blushing?
What would I have to blush about?
You tell me.
It's of no interest to you, I'm certain. It's a book.
I can see that.
It's one of Varric's tales. Swords and Shields, the latest chapter.
The latest chapter, meaning you've read them all?
Not since this all began. We've been busy.
That's just her favorite.
Nobody asked you, Tevinter.
I couldn't finish the last one you lent me. I actually feel dumber for having tried.
It's literature. Smutty literature. Whatever you do, don't tell Varric.
Why not? I think Varric would be pleased to have another fan.
Pleased? Yes, that's one word for it. They're terrible. And magnificent. And this one ends in a cliffhanger. I know Varric is working on the next. He must be. You could ask him to finish it. Command him to... Pretend you don't know this about me.
Need something?
Cassandra's waiting for the next issue of Swords and Shields.
I must have heard that wrong. It sounded like you just said that Cassandra read my books.
She's a pretty big fan, in fact.
Are we talking about the same Cassandra? Tall, grumpy seeker, like stabbing things? Wait, did you say the romance serial? Huh. She'll be waiting for a while, then. I haven't finished it and wasn't planning to. That book is easily the worst I've ever written. The last issue barely sold enough to pay for the ink.
I was hoping to give it to Cassandra as a gift.
Oh, come on. That's just cruel. Even the Seeker doesn't deserve that. So, you want me to finish writing the latest issue of my worst serial for Cassandra? Oh, that's such a terrible idea. I have to do it. On one condition. I get to be there when you give her the book.
You've got a deal.
I'll get to work then. You know, the fact that the book is terrible just makes it more worthwhile somehow.
Inquisitor, meet Hawke, the champion of Kirkwall.
Though I don't use that title much anymore.
Hawke, the Inquisitor. I figured you might have some friendly advice about Corypheus. You and I did fight him, after all.
Impressive view. Reminds me of my home in Kirkwall. I had a balcony that overlooked the whole city. I loved it at first. But after a while, all I could see were the people out there depending on me.
You're lucky it was just a single city. I've got half of Thedas.
You're doing everything you can to protect them.
Does it ever get any easier?
I'll let you know. I don't envy you, Inquisitor. But I may be able to help you.
Varric said that you fought Corypheus before.
Fought and killed. The Grey Wardens were holding him, and he somehow used his connection to the Darkspawn to influence them.
Corypheus got into their heads, messed with their minds, turned them against each other.
If the Wardens have disappeared, they could have fallen under his control again.
If that's what happened to the Wardens, do you think we can free them?
It's possible, but we need to know more first. I've got a friend in the Wardens. He was investigating something unrelated for me. His name is Stroud. The last time we spoke, he was worried about corruption in the Warden ranks. Since then, nothing.
Corypheus would certainly qualify as corruption in the ranks. Did your friend disappear with them?
No. He told me he'd be hiding in an old smuggler's cave near Crestwood.
If you didn't know about Corypheus, what were you doing with the Wardens?
The Templars in Kirkwall were using a strange form of lyrium. It was red. I'd hoped the Wardens could tell me more about it.
Corypheus had Templars with him at Haven. They looked like they'd been exposed to the lyrium you describe.
Hopefully, my friend and the Wardens will know more.
I appreciate the help.
I'm doing this as much for myself as for you. Corypheus is my responsibility. I thought I'd killed him before. This time I'll make sure of it.
Good to see you safe, Inquisitor. We've got trouble ahead.
If you're on edge, I should alert the entire Inquisition.
Or increase my hazard pay. That's an option.
Are things that bad?
Crestwood was the site of a flood 10 years ago during the Blight. It's not the only rift in the area, but after it appeared, corpses started walking out of the lake. You'll have to fight through them to get to the cave where Sir Hawke's Grey Warden friend is hiding.
Have any undead attacked the camp?
We've had a few shamblers, but most head toward the village below. Maybe someone in Crestwood can tell you how to get to the rift in the lake. Maker knows they'll want help. Good luck, and please be safe.
Are you here to stop the undead?
We will, right? I mean, these people are terrified.
The undead are appearing because of a rift in the Fade. How can I get to it?
The light in the lake? It's coming from the caves below Old Crestwood. Darkspawn flooded it 10 years ago during the Blight. Wiped out the village, killing the refugees we took in.
I saw a dam. If we use it to drain the lake, I can get to that Fade Rift.
Drain the... There must be some other way.
We are trying to help. The Inquisitor is the only one who can close the rifts.
You'd have to evict the bandits in the old fort to use the dam. I can't ask you to risk your life.
Crestwood can't last much longer. I don't want to leave without doing what I can.
I suppose it must come to this. This key unlocks the gate to the dam controls past the fort. The rift must be in the caves under Old Crestwood. But, Inquisitor, I would not linger there.
Tell me about your village.
It's seen happier days. We farm what we can, trade with the merchants who travel the King's Road. We only want peace, Your Worship. It's all we've ever wanted.
Until later.
Of course.
A letter of confession from the mayor. It says he was the one who flooded Old Crestwood 10 years ago to stop the Blight from spreading.
I knew he was nervous about more than the undead.
Villagers learn about this, they're not going to be happy.
What a sad mess. Will the Inquisition bring him in?
My contact with the Warden should be at the back of the cave.
A group of wardens were protecting a villager from corpses out near Crestwood.
They were likely hunting my friend. I'm glad they didn't come looking for people to help in here. They might well be good men, but they've been given bad orders. Just us. I brought the Inquisitor.
My name is Taud, and I'm at your service, Inquisitor.
I'll take all the help I can get. I know the Wardens have troubles of their own. I wonder, though, might those troubles have anything to do with Corypheus?
I fear it is so. When my friend Hawke slew Corypheus, Weishaupt was happy to put the matter to rest. But an archdemon can survive wounds that seem fatal, and I feared Corypheus might possess the same power. My investigation uncovered clues, but no proof. Then, not long after, every warden in Orlais began to hear the calling.
Maker, why didn't you tell me?
It was a Grey Warden matter. I was bound by an oath of secrecy.
Is the calling some sort of Grey Warden ritual?
The calling tells a warden that the Blight will soon claim him. Starts with dreams. Then come whispers in his head. The warden says his farewells and goes to the Deep Roads to meet his death in combat.
And every Grey Warden in Orlais is hearing that right now. They think they're dying.
Yes. Likely because of Corypheus. If the Wardens fall, Who will stand against the next blight? It is our greatest fear.
So, Corypheus isn't controlling them. He's bluffing them with this calling, and they're falling for it.
Is the calling they're hearing real? Or is Corypheus mimicking it somehow?
I know not. Even as a senior warden, I had heard only the vaguest whispers of Corypheus. The wardens believe that this calling is real, and they will act accordingly. That is all we know for certain.
You said all the wardens are hearing the calling. Does that include you?
Sadly, yes. It lurks like a wolf in the shadows around a campfire. The creature that makes this music has never known the love of the Maker, but at times, I almost understand it. We must uncover what Corypheus has done and end it. This cannot stand.
How can Corypheus make all these wardens hear the calling?
I cannot say. We know little about him, save that he is dangerous. He is a magister, as well as a darkspawn, and speaks with the voice of the Blight. That lets him affect the minds of wardens, since we are tied to the Blight ourselves. It must be how he created this false calling.
Now the wardens think they're dying and have stopped thinking clearly. That won't go well.
We are the only ones who can slay archdemons. Without us, the next blight will consume the world. Warden Commander Clarel spoke of a blood magic ritual to prevent future blights before we all perished. When I protested the plan as madness, my own comrades turned on me. Grey Wardens are gathering here, in the western approach. It is an ancient Tevinter ritual tower. Meet me there, and we will find answers.
I hoped you'd stop by.
Did you ever cross paths with Hawke and Kirkwall?
A few times. Hawke stood with the mages when the fighting broke out.
You were on opposing sides.
At first. In the end, Hawke's stand against Knight Commander Meredith saved us all. I'm grateful for any help she can offer.
Is there anything I should know?
I'd gotten used to mages disliking me on principle. Vivienne's views on Templars are surprisingly traditional.
I've never disliked you on principle.
Thank you.
You and the Red Templars leader seem to have personal history.
When I arrived in Kirkwall, Samson and I shared quarters. He seemed a decent man at first. Knight Commander Meredith later expelled Samson for erratic behavior. He ended up begging on Kirkwall streets. He committed further crimes, but managed to evade the Order's justice. Now Samson serves Corypheus as his loyal general.
Why do you think Samson joined Corypheus?
He had a chronic lyrium addiction. He spent every last coin buying it from local smugglers. Perhaps Corypheus flattered his vanity, gave him purpose as well as lyrium. Perhaps that's all it took.
Sounds like Samson had a miserable life.
The Order expelled him, but he had choices. He could have found another path. I don't understand how he became so powerful. Even with Red Lyrium, Samson's glory days are long behind him.
You knew where Hawke was all along!
You're damned right I did.
You conniving little shit!
You kidnapped me! You interrogated me! What did you expect?
Hey, enough! You're taking his side? I said enough! We needed someone to lead this Inquisition. First, Liliana and I searched for the Hero of Ferelden, but she had vanished. Then, we looked for Hawke, but she was gone too. We thought it all connected, but no. It was just you. You who kept her from us.
The Inquisition has a leader.
Hawke would have been at the Conclave if anyone could have saved Most Holy...
Varric's not responsible for what happened at the Conclave.
I was protecting my friend.
Varric is a liar, Inquisitor. A snake. Even after the Conclave, when we needed Hawke most, Varric kept her secret.
She's with us now. We're on the same side.
We all know whose side you're on, Varric. It will never be the Inquisition's.
That's unworthy of you.
I must not think of what could have been. We have so much at stake. Go, Varric. Just go.
You know what I think? If Hawke had been at the temple, she'd be dead too. You people have done enough to her.
I believed him. He spun his story for me and I swallowed it. If I'd just explained what was at stake, if I'd just made him understand. But I didn't, did I? I didn't explain why we needed Hawke. I'm such a fool.
What if you hadn't believed him and you'd tracked Hawke down?
Honestly. Hawke might not even have agreed to become Inquisitor. She supported the Mage Rebellion after all. She wouldn't have trusted me for a second. But this isn't about Hawke, or even Varric. Not truly. I should have been more careful. I should have been smarter. I don't deserve to be here.
You're too hard on yourself, Cassandra.
Not hard enough, I think.
You can't believe that.
I want you to know, I have no regrets. Maybe if we'd found Hawke or the Hero of Ferelden, the Maker wouldn't have needed to send you. But he did. I don't know what's to come, but you're more than I could have hoped for.
That got a little heated. You all right?
Well, that depends. How angry is Cassandra? I wasn't trying to keep secrets. I told the Inquisition everything that seemed important at the time.
I bet Cassandra regrets how things went back there. You should talk to her.
I appreciate that you're trying to keep the peace, but things between me and the Seeker are as good as they'll get. I keep hoping none of this is real. Maybe it's all some bullshit from the Fade and it'll just disappear. I know I need to do better. I'm sorry.
Mayor Gregory Dedrick of Crestwood is present for betraying his own constituents. He confesses that, 10 years ago, he flooded Old Crestwood to kill refugees and villagers touched by the Blight. The mayor claims it was to spare the rest of Crestwood, but we only have his word.
The mayor has anything to say in his defense, let him speak.
There's no cure for the Blight! But I couldn't convince anyone to leave a sick child or husband behind.
So you herded the infected into one place and flooded Old Crestwood. Were no innocents caught in the waters?
Nearly everyone in the village had the Blight, I swear it! Have mercy. I couldn't tell the survivors I'd drowned their own families to save them. I couldn't.
You lied for 10 years about your crime, then fled after confessing your guilt. For avoiding justice, you are exiled from Ferelden. I doubt the Crown will disagree.
I knew your coming meant the end, one way or another.
As leader of the Inquisition, you... There's something I must tell you.
Whatever it is, I'm willing to listen.
Right. Thank you. Lyrium grants Templars our abilities,
but it controls us as well. Those cut off suffer. Some go mad, others die. We have secured a reliable source of lyrium for the Templars here. But I no longer take it.
You stopped?
When I joined the Inquisition. It's been months now.
Cullen, if this can kill you...
It hasn't yet. After what happened in Kirkwall, I couldn't. I will not be bound to the Order or that life any longer. Whatever the suffering, I accept it. But I would not put the Inquisition at risk. I've asked Cassandra to watch me. If my ability to lead is compromised, I will be relieved from duty.
Are you in pain?
I can endure it.
Thank you for telling me. I respect what you're doing.
Thank you, Inquisitor. The Inquisition's army must always take priority. Should anything happen, I will defer to Cassandra's judgment.
Something wrong with your tea?
It is tea. I detest this stuff. But this morning, I need to shake the dreams from my mind. I may also need a favor.
You just have to ask.
One of my oldest friends has been captured by mages, forced into slavery. I heard the cry for help as I slept.
I'd be happy to help. What did these mages use to capture your friend? Blood magic?
A summoning circle, I would imagine.
I'm sorry?
My friend is a spirit of wisdom. Unlike the spirits clamoring to enter our world through the rifts, it was dwelling quite happily in the Fade. It was summoned against its will, and wants my help to gain its freedom and return to the Fade.
I thought spirits wanted to find their way into this world.
Some do, certainly. Just as many Orlesian peasants wish they could journey to exotic Rivain. But not everyone wants to go to Rivain. My friend is an explorer, seeking lost wisdom and reflecting it. It would happily discuss philosophy with you, but it had no wish to come here physically.
Do you have any idea what the mages want with your friend?
No. It knows a great deal of lore and history, but a mage could learn that simply by speaking to it in the Fade. It is possible that they seek information it does not wish to give, and intend to torture it.
All right. Let's go get your friend.
Thank you. I got a sense of my friend's location before I awoke. I'll mark it on our map.
Inquisitor, welcome to the Exalted Plains, a place with a long and bloody history. Even now, the region is volatile. This was a front in the Civil War. Now there's rebels called the Freemen of the Dales, recently emerged and adding to the chaos.
What history were you talking about?
After the fall of Halam Sharal, what remained of the Elven army met the forces of the Exalted March here. When offered a chance to lay down their arms and surrender, they refused.
This rebel group, tell me more about them.
They seem to be simple deserters, tired of fighting and dying for either the Empress or the Grand Duke. Now they want the Dales for their own. Worse, they're more organized than we anticipated. Be wary.
What else can you tell me?
Scouts have sighted Dalish elves. There must be a clan camp somewhere on the plains.
That will be all. Thank you.
With the rifts and the undead, the Orlesians have lost ground. Most have been driven back to their forts. We have to stabilize the region, allowing the Imperial Army to reestablish its presence. Good luck, Your Worship. You'll need it.
Anything you want to share, Solas?
That is not its natural form. It's been corrupted.
Corrupted?
Forced to act against its original purpose. What did they do? What did they do? What did they do? Perhaps we should ask.
A mage! You're not with the bandits? Do you have any lyrium potions? Most of us are exhausted. We've been fighting that demon.
You summon that demon!
Except it was a spirit of wisdom at the time. You made it kill. You twisted it against its purpose. I understand how it might be confusing to someone who has not studied demons, but after you help us, I can... We are not here to help you.
Word of advice? I'd hold off on explaining how demons work to my friend here.
Listen to me. I was one of the foremost experts in the Kirkwall circle. Shut up. You summoned it to protect you from the bandits.
I... Yes.
You bound it to obedience, then commanded it to kill. That is when it turned. The summoning circle. We break it, we break the binding. No orders to kill, no conflict with its nature, no demon.
What?
The binding is the only thing keeping the demon from killing us. Whatever it was before, it is a monster now. Inquisitor, please!
I'll do everything I can to save your friend, Solas.
Thank you. We must hurry!
Tell Arbalos and Azel at Alim. Mami lava halani. Mala suledin adas. Magilani midinan.
Manu vinin. Dareth Sharan.
I'm sorry, Solas.
Don't be. We gave it a moment's peace before the end. That's more than it might have had. All that remains now is them.
Thank you. We would not have risked a summoning, but the roads are too dangerous to travel unprotected.
You tortured and killed my friend.
We didn't know. It was just a spirit. The book said it could help us.
Damn them all. I need some time alone. I will meet you back at Skyhold. Inquisitor.
How are you, Solas?
It hurts. It always does. But I will survive.
Thank you for coming back.
You were a true friend. You did everything you could to help. I could hardly abandon you now.
Where did you go?
I found a quiet spot and went to sleep. I visited the place in the Fade where my friend used to be. It's empty. But there are stirrings of energy in the void. Someday something new may grow there.
What happens when a spirit dies?
It isn't the same for mortals. The energy of spirits returns to the Fade. If the idea giving the spirit form is strong, or if the memory has shaped other spirits, it may someday rise again.
You're saying your friend might come back?
No, not really. A spirit's natural state is peaceful semi-existence. It is rare to be able to reflect reality. Something similar may reform one day, but it might have a different personality. It would likely not remember me. It would not be the friend I knew.
I'll let you get back to work.
All right. Thank you again.
I can keep staring at this, but I won't get any closer.
Something I can help you with?
Yes. Possibly. We saw so many Red Templars at the assault on Haven. Perhaps all that was left of the Order. What we didn't see was Lord Seeker Lucius. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars, or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
Why imprisoned? He could just as easily have killed them.
Not easily. But yes, they may be dead. But the Seekers began this war against the Mages. They cannot have simply vanished. There must be a trail we can follow, yet so far I have only discovered hints.
But they could have ended up just like the Red Templars.
Seekers do not use lyrium. I assume Corypheus gained control of the Templars by corrupting the lyrium they were already taking. To do the same to a Seeker, you'd have to force the lyrium upon him. That may be what happened, but it couldn't have begun that way. We're missing a piece of the puzzle, Inquisitor. I need to find it.
Finding them obviously means a lot to you.
I left the Order, but I can never abandon them. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate it. As the Seekers of Truth have proven resistant to the effects of Red Lyrium, the Elder One has seen fit to place them in your care. Reclaim your destiny, and know that the Elder One expects your devotion as repayment. Signed by Lord Samson, Commander of the Red Templars. Does Corypheus not realize the promises want the world to end? What use are they to him?
So Corypheus sold the Seekers to these cultists?
And they leapt at the chance, of course. But this doesn't explain how he captured the Seekers in the first place, or what's been done with them. We must keep looking.
The letter said Seekers were resistant to Red Lyrium.
Our abilities grant us many gifts, but a resistance to Red Lyrium's corruption? That seems strange. Although it would explain why none have numbered among the Red Templars. And thus Seekers would be useless to Corypheus. He would have no leash to hold us.
You sound worried.
I am. The Seekers are my family. Daniel! Daniel! Can you hear me?
Cassandra... It... is you. You're alive.
As are you. I'm so glad I found you.
No, they... put a demon inside me. It's... tearing me up.
What? You can't be possessed. That's impossible.
I'm not possessed. They... fed me things. I can feel it growing.
The Promisers will pay for what they've done.
No. The Lord Seeker.
Of course we'll find him. If he lives, we'll...
Lucius betrayed us, Cassandra. He sent us here. One by one. An important mission, he said. Lies. He was here with them all along. He's still working with them.
But we met Lord Seeker Lucius in Valroyo. He couldn't have been here.
That wasn't him. It was a demon. Masquerading.
What? How could that be?
The Lord Seeker allowed it. He let the demon take command while he...
came here.
Cassandra.
Now is not the time for sympathy.
Wait. Don't leave me like this, please.
You should have come with me. You didn't believe in the war any more than I did.
You know me. I wanted that promotion.
Go to the Maker's side, Daniel. You will be welcome. Lord Seeker Lucius.
Cassandra, with a woman I can only assume is the new Inquisitor.
You must be very proud of your handiwork.
I presume you know we Seekers of Truth were once the original Inquisition. Oh yes. We fought to restore order in a time of madness long ago, as you do now. And we became proud. We sought to remake the world, to make it better. But what did we create? The Chantry, the Circles of Magi, a war that will see no end.
We are not the original Inquisition.
Of course you say that now.
So you did all this because you hate our order?
We Seekers are abominations, Cassandra. We created a decaying world and fought to preserve it even as it crumbled. We had to be stopped. You don't believe me? See for yourself. The secrets of our order passed to me after the former Lord Seeker was slain. The war with the mages had already begun, but it was not too late for me to do the right thing.
And this was the right thing?
Lord Seeker, what you've done...
I know. What Corypheus did with the Templars does not matter. I have seen the future. I have created a new order to replace the old. The world will end so we can start anew. A pure beginning. Join us, Cassandra. It is the Maker's will.
This tome has passed from Lord Seeker to Lord Seeker since the time of the old Inquisition. And now it falls to me.
You all right? You look drained.
On the contrary, it's a delight. I'm riveted.
Oh, you're joking.
I assume you know about the Rite of Tranquility. The last resort used on mages in the Circle, leaving them unable to cast, but depriving them of dreams and all emotion. It should only be used on those who cannot control their abilities, but that has not always been the case.
You mutilate mages.
I always thought it a necessary evil. What finally began the Mage Rebellion was the discovery the Rite of Tranquility could be reversed. The Lord Seeker at the time covered it up, harshly. There were deaths. It was dangerous knowledge. The shock of its discovery in addition to what happened in Kirkwall. But it appears we've always known how to reverse the rite, from the beginning.
So the rebellion could have been prevented.
Perhaps, but it was a long time coming, for many reasons. We created the Rite of Tranquility. I told you of my vigil, the months I spent emptying myself of all emotion. I was made tranquil and didn't even know. Then the vigil summoned a spirit of faith to touch my mind. That broke tranquility and gave me my abilities. The Seekers did not share that secret. Not with me, not with the chantry, not even with... There's more. Lucius was not wrong about the Order. I thought to rebuild the Seekers once victory was ours. Now I'm not certain it deserves to be rebuilt.
You said there was more in the book?
At some point, power becomes its own master. We cast aside ideals in favor of expedience and tell ourselves it was all necessary for the people. Will that happen to us, Inquisitor? Will we repeat history?
No. We're nothing like the Seekers.
I wonder how much we resemble what they used to be.
I don't think I've ever seen you so shaken.
I do not think the Seekers have been doing the Maker's work. Not truly. Perhaps we believed it once. The original Inquisition came to be during a terrible time. But now, we harbored secrets and let them fester. We acted to survive, but not to serve. That is not the Maker's work.
Rebuild the Seekers. Make them better than they were.
Thank you. I could not have done this on my own. What have you done now?
I get it, Seeker. You're still sore after our spat.
I'm not a child, Varric. Do not suggest I'm without reason.
A peace offering. The next chapter of Swords and Shields. I hear you're a fan.
This is your doing.
Oh, yes. Do you really think I'd miss this?
Well, if you're not interested, you're not interested. Still needs editing anyhow.
Wait!
You're probably wondering what happens to the Night Captain after the last chapter.
Nothing should happen to her. She was falsely accused.
Well, it turns out the guardsman...
Don't tell me!
This is the part where you thank the Inquisitor. I don't normally give sneak peeks, after all.
I... thank you.
Varric's the one you should be thanking.
I am but a humble servant to my loyal readers.
I wonder if I have time to read the first part.
Don't forget to tell all your friends, if you have any. Completely worth it. Corypheus is back. Oh, shit.
You said he was a darkspawn or a magister. What is he really?
I'm not sure. I don't think Corypheus really knows either. He's definitely a darkspawn, but when we found him, it was pretty obvious he hadn't heard that. He thinks he's a magister, a priest of Dumat, in fact. He says he broke into the Golden City, like in the chantry tale.
If you and Hawke defeated him once, we can do it again.
We didn't just think Corypheus was dead. He was dead. No pulse, no breath, full of stab wounds. There wasn't a lot of room for doubt. It makes me wonder. I thought the wardens imprisoned Corypheus to use him. Maybe they did it because he can't be killed.
How did you and Hawke even wind up in a Grey Warden prison for ancient darkspawn?
Corypheus sent people after Hawke. He actually got control of an entire Carta clan. Made them drink darkspawn blood. Weird shit. We tracked the Carta to an old dwarven fort or something in the mountains. Of course, it turned out to be a trap. They needed Hawk's blood to open the locks holding Corypheus, and they drew us into the prison to get it.
There has to be a way to defeat Corypheus. We'll find it, don't worry.
I hope you're right. Maker's breath, what have I let loose?
You had nothing to do with this, Varric.
I was the one who led Hawke to Corypheus. If I hadn't tracked the Carta to that ruin. But you've got more important things to do than listen to me worry. Just let me know when you want something shot.
Gloat all you like. I have this one.
Are you sassing me, Commander? I didn't know you had it in you.
Why do I even... Inquisitor.
Leaving, are you? Does this mean I win?
Please don't stop on my account.
All right. Your move.
You need to come to terms with my inevitable victory. You'll feel much better.
Really? Because I just won. And I feel fine.
Don't get smug. There will be no living with you.
I should return to my duties as well. Unless you would care for a game.
Prepare the board, Commander.
As a child, I played this with my sister. She would get this stuck-up grin whenever she won, which was all the time. My brother and I practiced together for weeks. Now, the look on her face the day I finally won. Between serving the Templars and the Inquisition, I haven't seen them in years. I wonder if she still plays.
You have siblings?
Two sisters and a brother.
Where are they now?
They moved to South Reach after the Blight. I do not write to them as often as I should. Ah, it's my turn.
You should keep in practice for when you see your sister again.
This may be the longest we've gone without discussing the Inquisition or related matters. To be honest, I appreciate the distraction.
We should spend more time together.
I would like that.
Me too.
You said that. We should finish our game, right? My turn? And this one's mine.
It seems luck favored you today.
So it has.
Anything interesting?
A letter regarding Felix, Alexius's son. He went to the Magisterium, stood on the Senate floor and told them of you. A glowing testimonial, I'm informed. No news on the reaction, but everyone back home is talking. Felix always was as good as his word.
Was?
He's dead. The Blight caught up with him.
Are you all right?
He was ill, and thus on borrowed time anyhow.
That doesn't mean you can't regret his death.
I know. Felix used to sneak me treats from the kitchens when I was working late in his father's study. Don't get into trouble on my behalf, I tell him. I like trouble, he'd say. Tevinter could use more mages like him. Those who put the good of others above themselves.
Were the two of you...
Felix and I? What an odd question. No, I had no intention of abusing Alexius's hospitality by seducing his son. Not that I've been proper my whole life by any means. It wasn't like that. Even in illness, Felix was the best of us. With him around, you knew things could be better.
You make it sound like he was a better person than you.
What a mad thing to say. Few people are better than I. Very well, a better person, clearly, not nearly as handsome. Thankfully, Felix wasn't the only decent sort kicking around Thedas.
Inquisitor, I was... Do you have a moment? What were you like before the anchor? Has it affected you? Changed you in any way? Your mind? Your morals? Your spirit?
I don't believe so.
Ah.
Why do you ask?
You show a wisdom I have not seen since... since my deepest journeys into the ancient memories of the Fade. You are not what I expected.
I don't think of myself as different from anyone.
Perhaps not in the form of your body, no. But you have shown a subtlety in your actions. A wisdom that goes against everything I know of your people.
I do what I can.
You are modest. So many would use this Inquisition as a blunt instrument in their rise to power. But not you.
So what does this mean, Solas?
It means that I respect you deeply, Inquisitor. And I have disturbed you enough for one evening.
Yes?
I thought we could talk. Alone?
Alone? I mean, of course. It's a nice day.
What?
There was something you wished to discuss.
Cullen, I care for you, and...
What's wrong?
You left the Templars, but do you trust mages? Could you think of me as anything more?
I could. I mean, I do think of you, and what I might say in this sort of situation.
What's stopping you?
You're the Inquisitor. We're at war, and you... I didn't think it was possible.
And yet I'm still here.
So you are. It seems too much to ask, but I want to.
Commander! You wanted a copy of Sister Leliana's report.
What?
Sister Leliana's report? You wanted it delivered without delay. Or to your office. Right.
If you need to...
I'm sorry. That was, really nice.
That was what I wanted.
Oh. Good. I hoped you'd stop by.
Do you have some time?
For you, always.
Commander of the Inquisition and the Herald of Andraste. I will have people talking.
You wouldn't believe how quickly gossip spreads through the barracks.
Does it bother you?
I would rather our private affairs remain that way. But if there were nothing here for people to talk about, I would regret it more.
The day you kissed me on the battlements, how long had you wanted to do that?
Longer than I should admit. Honestly, I couldn't keep my eyes off you. But we'd only just met.
You don't have much patience for nobility. I'm glad my title didn't scare you off.
I hadn't considered. I have no title outside the Inquisition. I hope that doesn't... I mean, does it bother you?
No. If you care for me, that's all that matters. I wasn't trying to put you on the spot.
I'm not very good at this, am I? If I seem unsure, it's because it's been a long time since I've wanted anyone in my life. I wasn't expecting to find that here. Or you.
Perhaps we can talk later.
I would hope so.
What do you think about the people who have gathered?
Which, the ones who do things or the ones who give orders?
What do you think about our spy master, ambassador, and commander?
Liliana is pretty in places. I swear I've seen her, too. Or heard she used to play. But that'd be mad. Now, Josephine, she's as good at humbling her kind as I am. Just with less mess. Knows her business, if you have to have it. And your Cullen Woolen.
Cully Woolly.
Lots of men under him. Needs a woman over him. Because positions.
We'll talk later.
Good, right? I'll be here.
Has Dorian done something wrong?
No, thankfully. It's nothing like that. I have been in contact with his family. House Pavas, out of Carinas. Are you familiar with them?
He's mentioned his family. They don't appear to be on good terms.
Yes. I believe you're correct. The family sent a letter describing the estrangement from their son and pleading for my aid. They've asked to arrange a meeting quietly without telling him. They fear it's the only way he'll come. Since you seem to be on good terms with the young man, I'd hoped...
Just what kind of meeting do they have in mind?
I believe they just want to talk, to understand why Dorian felt he had to come here. Somewhat private, away from Skyhold, but not in Tevinter. You make them nervous, I think. They don't understand why he's here with the Inquisition. They want him to come home.
What happens if Dorian doesn't agree?
Hopefully that will be the end of it. If not, well, that's why you should be there.
Why would his family contact you?
Because they don't know you, Inquisitor. I am not of the Imperial Chantry, but they know what I represent. These are parents concerned about the welfare of their son. How could I not do whatever possible? I would speak to the young man myself, but he does not care for me. Thus I come to you. If any good can come of this, we must try.
They don't want Dorian to know? That seems odd.
They believe the young man would refuse, and the letter implies he'd have cause. Yet, they are remorseful for whatever came before. This is a chance for dialogue. There is deceit in bringing the young man to this meeting without his foreknowledge, I know. But does it not lead to a greater kindness if there is potential for reconciliation?
Are you sure this isn't some kind of trap? I mean, the secrecy.
That did occur to me. What if it is a plot of those mages, the Venatori? Another reason to put this in your hands, Inquisitor. I pray that isn't the case, but if it is, you are far better equipped than I to respond to such treachery.
If you think I'm going to trick Dorian into meeting his family...
Oh, I feared you might say that. The family will send a retainer to meet the young man at the Red Cliff Tavern, to take him onward. If he truly does not wish this reunion, he can always end the matter there. I pray you change your mind, Inquisitor. Perhaps their letter will persuade you. If there is any chance of success in this, it behooves us to act.
It occurs to me that you're a mage.
That just occurred to you?
I meant, you must have been part of the Circle of Magi in the South. Meaning, you were locked away like a criminal, at least until you rebelled. It's such a bizarre notion to me.
It's bizarre to me as well.
I believe this is a moment where we stand in mutual recognition of mankind's folly. It's more surprising that everyone would take the idea of a mage inquisitor so calmly. Maybe it's not calm. Maybe the Antivan crows are swimming in gold from all the contracts on your life. Good luck with that, by the way. Grand fun being the one in charge.
Dorian, there's a letter you need to see.
A letter? Is it a naughty letter? A humorous proposal from some Antivan dowager?
Not quite. It's from your father.
From my father? I see. And what does Magister Hallward want, pray tell?
A meeting.
Show me this letter. I know my son? What my father knows of me would barely fill a thimble. This is so typical. I'm willing to bet this retainer is a henchman, hired to knock me on the head and drag me back to Tevinter.
You think your father would actually do that?
No, although I wouldn't put it past him. Let's go. Let's meet this so-called family retainer. If it's a trap, we escape and kill everyone. You're good at that. If it's not, I send the man back to my father with a message that he can stick his alarm in his wit's end.
There seems to be bad blood between you and your family.
Interesting turn of phrase. But you're correct. They don't care for my choices, nor I for theirs.
Because you wouldn't get married? Because you left?
That too.
Let's go meet this retainer then.
I wonder how much my father paid this man to wait around just in case I showed. We'll find out soon enough. Uh-oh, nobody's here. This doesn't bode well.
Dorian.
Father. So the whole story about the family retainer was just, what, a smokescreen?
Then you were told. I apologize for the deception, Inquisitor. I never intended for you to be involved.
Of course not. Magister Parvis couldn't come to Skyhold and be seen with the dread Inquisitor. What would people think? What is this exactly, Father? Ambush? Kidnapping? Warm family reunion?
This is how it has always been.
You went through all of this to get Dorian here. Talk to him.
Yes, Father. Talk to me.
Let me hear how mystified you are by my anger.
Dorian, there's no need to.
I prefer the company of men. My father disapproves.
I'll need you to explain that.
Did I stutter? Men and the company thereof, as in sex. Surely you've heard of it.
This is not exactly news, Dorian.
And why should it be? Why should anyone care? I have no idea.
This display is uncalled for.
No, it is called for. You called for it by luring me here.
This is not what I wanted.
I'm never what you wanted, Father. Or had you forgotten?
That's a big concern in Tevinter, then?
Only if you're trying to live up to an impossible standard. Every Tevinter family is intermarrying to distill the perfect mage, perfect body, perfect mind, the perfect leader. It means every perceived flaw, every aberration is deviant and shameful. It must be hidden.
Your father might be here to reach out. You could give him a chance.
Let's just go. Dorian, please. If you'll only listen to me.
Why? So you can spout more convenient lies?
He taught me to hate blood magic. The resort of the weak mind.
Those are his words. But what was the first thing you did when your precious heir refused to play pretend for the rest of his life? You tried to change me.
I only wanted what was best for you.
You wanted the best for you? Your fucking legacy. Anything for that.
Don't leave it like this, Dorian. You'll never forgive yourself.
Tell me why you came.
If I knew, I would drive you to the Inquisition.
You didn't. I joined the Inquisition because it's the right thing to do. Once, I had a father who would have known that.
Once, I had a son who trusted me, a trust I betrayed. I only wanted to talk to him, to hear his voice again, to ask him to forgive me.
He says we're alike. Too much pride. Once I would have been overjoyed to hear him say that. Now I'm not certain. I don't know if I can forgive him.
Are you all right?
No, not really. Thank you for bringing me out there. It wasn't what I expected, but it's something. Maker knows what you must think of me now, after that whole display.
I think you're very brave.
Brave?
It's not easy to abandon tradition and walk your own path.
At any rate, time to drink myself into a stupor. It's been that sort of day. Join me sometime, if you've a mind.
Inquisitor, if you're looking for the commander, he's gone to speak with Seeker Pentagast.
You asked for my opinion, and I've given it. Why would you expect it to change?
I expect you to keep your word. It's relentless. I can't...
You give yourself too little credit.
If I'm unable to fulfill what vows I kept, then nothing good has come of this. Would you rather save face than admit... Forgive me.
And people say I'm stubborn. This is ridiculous. Cullen told you that he's no longer taking Lyrium?
Yes. And I respect his decision.
As do I. Not that he's willing to listen. Cullen has asked that I recommend a replacement for him. I refused. It's not necessary. Besides, it would destroy him. He's come so far.
Why didn't he come to me?
We had an agreement long before you joined us. As a seeker, I could evaluate the dangers. And he wouldn't want to risk your disappointment.
Is there anything we can do to change his mind?
If anyone could, it's you. Mages have made their suffering known, but Templars never have. They are bound to the Order, mind and soul, with someone always holding their lyrium leash. Cullen has a chance to break that leash, to prove to himself, and anyone who would follow suit, that it's possible. He can do this. I knew that when we met in Kirkwall. Talk to him. Decide if now is the time.
Maker's breath. I didn't hear you enter. Forgive me.
Cullen, if you need to talk...
You don't have to... I never meant for this to interfere.
Are you going to be all right?
Yes. I don't know. You asked what happened to Ferelden's Circle. It was taken over by abominations. The Templars, my friends, were slaughtered. I was tortured. They tried to break my mind, and I... How can you be the same person after that? Still, I wanted to serve. They sent me to Kirkwall. I trusted my Knight Commander, and for what? Her fear of mages ended in madness. Kirkwall's Circle fell. Innocent people died in the streets. Can't you see why I want nothing to do with that life?
Of course I can. I...
Don't. You should be questioning what I've done. I thought this would be better. That I would regain some control over my life, but... These thoughts won't leave me. How many lives depend on our success? I swore myself to this cause. I will not give less to the Inquisition than I did to Chantry. I should be taking it. I should be taking it.
This doesn't have to be about the Inquisition. Is this what you want?
No. But these memories have always haunted me. If they become worse, if I cannot endure this...
You can.
All right.
It started out helping, taking the fear away. I won't take too much. I am not that.
I'd like to talk with you about Templars.
They're heavy with forgotten songs, like Varric. Some of them are too loud. It's hard to stay near them. Cullen is softer, but demons asked questions that hurt him. Evangeline was kinder. I want to explain, but I... Rhys's mother spoke to spirits, but not to him. Then she died for a Templar he loved. Words just bounce off the edges.
What's your general opinion of Templars?
Some like hurting mages. It makes them happy, or less afraid, or... Dreams again. Woke up shaking, stalking the ground for one who looks like her. Always some rule being broken. But... Not all Templars listen when whispers crawl around inside them. They try to protect people, like Cullen. The good ones remember that mages are people.
Can you tell me more about how the Templars feel to you?
They feel older than they look. They've been changed, and their bodies are incomplete now. The lyrium helps, but their bodies always want to connect to something older, bigger than they are. That's why they block magic. They reach for that other thing, and magic has no room to come in. Like when I listen to Varric.
Can you tell me more about how the Red Templars are different?
The Red Lyrium is different, darker, daggers under the skin. It eats you inside until you're nothing. They hear a different song. The song behind the door old whispers want opened. They are dead and dark and done.
I'll talk to you later.
How do you know?
I wanted to thank you. When you came to see me, if there's anything... This sounded much better in my head.
I trust you're feeling better?
Yes.
Is it always that bad?
The pain comes and goes. Sometimes I feel as if I'm back there. I should not have pushed myself so far that day.
I'm just glad you're all right.
I am. I've never told anyone what truly happened to me at Ferelden's Circle. I was not myself after that. I was angry. For years, that anger blinded me. I'm not proud of the man that made me. The way I saw mages, I'm not sure I would have cared about you. The thought of that sickens me. Now I can put some distance between myself and everything that happened. It's a start.
For what it's worth, I like who you are now.
Even after?
Cullen, I care about you. You've done nothing to change that.
What about you? You have troubles of your own. How are you holding up?
I'll feel better when we take down Corypheus.
As will I. He will not elude us forever.
Good to see you.
May I ask you something?
Always.
Do you think Templars should cease to exist?
No. I may have chosen to leave that life, but I respect those who remain. Magic ungoverned could tear the world apart. It's doing so now. Templars are trained and able to confront such dangers.
What would you suggest?
Some call the Circle a prison that can only breed resentment. Perhaps opportunities to work outside the Circle. A mixed military service or healers' clinics with Templar support. And there must be a safer way for Templars to leave. Templars can lose their memories to Lyrium. Some call it a gift, to forget the failed harrowings, the demons. Some atrocities haunt me still. But to lose what good I can recall. I nearly lost my mind once. It is no gift.
I like the sound of that.
I'm not sure it's the answer, but something needs to change.
You still regret the man you became after leaving Ferelden?
After the Ferelden Circle, I thought all mages were like the ones there. Knight Commander Meredith's methods were harsh, but they kept people safe.
You've said Meredith was unstable.
She was my Knight Commander. I had no reason to distrust her. She wasn't wrong about the Blood Mages in Kirkwall. Meredith encouraged my anger towards the mages. It was only so far it would go, and she knew that, too. I was her second in command. She kept decisions from me, those I would question. I believed she was serving the city. I never thought to question her, not until it was too late.
You can't control everything. You stood up to her in the end.
If I hadn't, would I be like her now? I wanted mages locked away as much as she did. I trusted they were treated reasonably well, but I should have done more. I should have looked into it. It's not yet enough. The Inquisition is my chance to atone. I will see it through.
That's all I wanted to know.
Should you require anything, I'll be here.
We have to reach the Empress before Corypheus. The only question is, how?
We know how. I have our way in. The real question is, where is our enemy hiding? At the urging of Grand Duchess Florian, the Empress is holding a ball. Absolutely everyone will be there. During the festivities, Celine will be meeting for peace talks with the usurper Duke Gaspard and Ambassador Priala. The assassin must be hiding within one of these factions.
What do we know about Duke Gaspard?
The man who would have been emperor. He's Celine's cousin, and was first in line to inherit the throne when Emperor Florian died. Celine outmaneuvered him. She won over the Council of Heralds, who hold authority over title disputes. She became Empress, and he a general in the Imperial Army. He's well-loved by the troops. He's also a Chevalier. Most of their number sided with him when he turned on the Empress.
Aren't the Chevaliers part of the army? Why would they follow the Duke?
Most Chevaliers are sworn to serve the crown, but that does not give them faith in the person wearing it. The Empress has tried to improve relations with Ferelden and Navarra. The Chevaliers see her as anti-military. They believe Gaspard could lead the Empire back to the glory of Draken's expansion years.
Who is this Ambassador Briala?
An ambassador in name only. She has organized the elves of Halam Sharal into an underground army. The Empress invited her to the peace talks in a bid to gain the elves' alliance in the war. That would be scandal enough, without the rumor that Briala is a jilted lover of Celine's. A personal grudge and a network of saboteurs at her command. Promising lead.
Wait, the elven leader is a jilted lover of the Empress?
It's not widely known. Just a rumor whispered among the palace servants a few years ago. If it's true and where to get out. The Empress and an elf. The scandal could destroy Celine's court. Even if a lie, Briala could use it to blackmail the Empress. She has some connection to the throne.
Tell me everything we know about the Empress.
Empress Celine is a renowned diplomat and reformer. She works tirelessly to secure peace for the Empire. Unfortunately, many Orlesians view peace as complacency. She has yet to name an heir, leaving the future of the Empire in doubt if anything happens to her. Especially when the next in line is her cousin Gaspard, who's made few friends on the Council of Heralds. Celine is surrounded at all times by countless guards, courtiers, servants, and vassals. What better place for an assassin to hide than the Empress's own household?
How can Gaspard still be next in line while he wages war against his Empress?
The title Grand Duke indicates that he was a prince before the Empress took the throne.
Do we need to go to the peace talks? The Empress must have personal guards. We could just warn her she's in danger.
We've made the attempt, but it seems that our messages never reached her. Someone intercepted them.
It's better that we don't leave this to chance. If Orlais falls to Corypheus, no land is safe.
We shouldn't waste any time. Let's go to the Winter Palace.
The political situation in Halam Sharal hangs by a thread. The Empress fears our presence could sever it. The Grand Duke is only too happy to have us at the ball as his guests, so our invitation comes from him. Whether we act as his allies or upset the balance of power, he gains an opportunity, if not a clear advantage.
Inquisitor Trevelyan, it is an honor to meet you at last. Bringing the rebel mages into the ranks of your army was a brilliant move. Imagine what the Inquisition could accomplish with the full support of the rightful Emperor of Orlais.
And which one was the rightful one again? I keep getting them confused.
The handsome, charming one, of course, my lady. I am not a man who forgets his friends, Inquisitor. You help me, I'll help you. My lady, are you prepared to shock the court by walking into the Grand Ball with a hateful usurper? They will be telling stories of this into the next age.
I can't imagine that crowd has seen anything better than us in their entire lives.
You're a woman after my own heart, my lady. As a friend, perhaps there is a matter you could undertake this evening. This elven woman, Briala, I suspect that she intends to disrupt the negotiations. My people have found these ambassadors all over the fortifications. Sabotage seems the least of their crimes.
That sounds like something I should look into.
Be as discreet as possible. I detest the game, but if we do not play it well, our enemies will make us look like villains. We're keeping the court waiting, Inquisitor. Shall we?
Inquisitor, a moment, if you please. I must warn you before you go inside. How you speak to the court is a matter of life and death. It is no simple matter of etiquette and protocol. Every word, every gesture is measured and evaluated for weakness.
Don't they sound delightful? I'm shocked we haven't invited the court to dinner at Skyhold.
The game is like wicked grace played to the death. You must never reveal your cards. When you meet the Empress, the eyes of the entire court will be upon you. You are safer staring down Corypheus.
Might be a good idea for the others to hear this warning. The bull in particular.
I'll have a few discreet words. Everything will be fine. And Raste watch over us all.
And now presenting Grand Duke Gaspard de Chalon, and accompanying him, Lady Inquisitor Trevelyan of the Ostwick Circle of Magi. Vanquisher of the rebel mages of Ferelden, crusher of the vile apostates of the Mage Underground, champion of the blessed Andraste herself.
Did you see their faces? Priceless.
Accompanying the Inquisitor, Seeker, Cassandra, Allegra, Portia, Calogera, Philomena.
Get on with it.
Pentagast, 14th cousin to the King of Navarra.
Cousin, my dear sister.
Grand Duke. We are always honored when your presence graces our court.
Don't waste my time with pleasantries, Celine. We have business to conclude.
We will meet for the negotiations after we have seen to our other guests.
Inquisitor?
Lady Inquisitor, we welcome you to the Winter Palace. Allow us to present our cousin, the Grand Duchess of Leeds, without whom this gathering would never have been possible.
What an unexpected pleasure. I was not aware the Inquisition would be part of our festivities. We will certainly speak later, Inquisitor.
Your arrival at court is like a cool wind on a summer's day.
I'm delighted to be here, Your Majesty.
We have heard much of your exploits, Inquisitor. They have made grand tales for long evenings. How do you find Halam Shiral?
I've never seen anything to equal the Winter Palace.
We hope you will find time to take in some of its beauties. Feel free to enjoy the pleasures of the ballroom, Inquisitor. We look forward to watching you dance.
Inquisitor, a word when you have a moment.
Jacket let out a little.
This dress uniform is preposterous. Formal armor would have been better.
What has she done?
Josephine! Oh, Josephine! Is this her?
Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister, Yvette Gabriella Montelier.
Delighted to meet you, Lady Montelier.
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything. Is it true? Rebel mages in Redcliffe were performing blood rites and orgies before you stopped them.
Where did you hear such nonsense?
Everyone in Antiva says so. Is it true?
Those stories are little more than wistful thinking, my lady.
Oh, how dull Redcliffe must have been, then.
Which power should the Inquisition throw its weight behind?
Celine has held the throne successfully for years. I see no profit in ousting her. Gaspard has run military campaigns, but never a kingdom. His transition would be, let us say, chaotic.
Tell me about yourself, Lady Yvette. This is the first time I've encountered any of Josephine's family.
She would forget to mention the artists. I've been studying painting under Antiva's royal tutors. You should be proud, Josie. I'm going to be exhibiting my work next season in the city's biggest salon.
Have you actually sat down and finished the painting yet?
I must wait for my inspiration.
And I must wait for your tutor's bills.
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette, stop.
Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
Hmm. She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette! That's... absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
Enjoying the ball?
I see many of...
The dancing is so dull, Your Worship. But the Empress's gallery is magnificent.
Yvette.
Sorry, Josie.
Go on, Josephine.
Half our royal must be empty. So many of the Empire's finest are in attendance. They've noticed the Empress paying you special attention, but they don't quite know how to take advantage of it yet. This uncertainty won't last long, I'm afraid.
I'll see you later.
Another time.
This ball is a waste of time, like all Orlesian foolishness. Let's find the Venatori collaborator and get out of here.
Have you witnessed anything noteworthy?
Nothing yet. I will let you know.
You don't seem to care much for the ball.
Orlesians pretend their petty squabbles are a game. Yes, let us treat murder, corruption, and deceit as delightful amusements. How wonderful. We are here to save Empress Celine, and it galls me. Why does she merit our protection? The Empire would be better off without her. Gaspard is the leader Orlais needs in this crisis.
You support the civil war?
Of course not. Chaos is what Corypheus wants, and we must oppose him. Were it up to me, however, I would let Celine fall and Gaspard take the throne. He would see the true threat, not spend his time throwing balls and writing letters.
Stay alert. We don't know where the enemy is hiding.
I'll be watching for trouble. The sooner we leave this place, the better.
Inquisitor, did you need something? The sooner we track down this infiltrator, the better.
I don't suppose you'd save a dance for me.
No, thank you.
Oh.
No, I didn't mean to make his breath. I've answered that question so many times, I'm rejecting it automatically. I'm not one for dancing. The Templars never attended balls.
Do you have any advice?
Orlesian social events don't fall within my area of expertise. There are a few here we can trust. Be careful.
Who do you think the Inquisition should support?
Gaspard's claim to the throne is fair. Orlais needs someone capable of responding to the crisis at hand. A military-minded leader seems the best option.
You've attracted a following. Who are all these people?
I don't know, but they won't leave me alone.
Not enjoying the attention, then?
Hardly. Anyway, yours... This is the only attention worth having.
Have you noticed anything out of the ordinary?
Not yet. It would be easier if people would stop talking to me. Other people. Not you.
We'll talk later.
I await your signal.
Good. I was hoping it would catch you. What did the Duke say?
He points the finger at Ambassador Briala.
The Ambassador is up to something, but she can't be our focus. The best place to strike at Celine is from her side. Empress Celine is fascinated by mysticism. Foreseeing the future, speaking with the dead, that sort of rubbish. She has an occult advisor. An apostate who charmed the Empress and key members of the court as if by magic. I've had dealings with her in the past. She is ruthless and capable of anything.
How can Celine openly keep an apostate in the Imperial Court?
The Imperial Court has always had an official position for a mage. Before now, it was little better than court jester. Vivian was the first to turn that appointment into a source of real political power. When the circles rebelled, technically every mage became an apostate. The word lost much of its strength.
It sounds exactly like the person we're looking for.
She's worth investigating. Can't be sure of anything here. Both leads point toward the guest wing. It's a promising place to start. I'll coordinate with our spies to see if I can find anything better. I will be in the ballroom if you need me.
You got anything that needs killing? Because the nobles keep messing with me, and they think I don't know they're doing it. This keeps up. I'm gonna wear somebody's skull as my fancy little mask.
Look at this with the eyes of a Ben Hasseroth, and tell me what you see.
It's a mess. Everyone's trying so hard to hide that they're walking around in plumage. Makes it tough to spot the dangerous lies, as opposed to the normal stuff. Oh. But that couple over there, with the silver masks? The woman's doing one of the nobles, and the guy's doing two different servants.
What do you think of the masks the nobles are wearing?
They're no good as disguises, and they don't cover the mouth or hide body language, so they're not much help for lying. As fashion goes, I don't know. I've seen dumber.
Anything catching your eye?
They've got these candied nuts with some kind of spice on them. It's sweet until you swallow, and then, bam, hot. Also, Orlais has some fine-looking redheads. I go more for the servants personally, less makeup. Nothing on the assassins, though.
Talk to you later, Bull.
My lady Inquisitor.
May we have a word? It is very important.
The Empress has sent us with a message for you.
How can I be certain this message is from the Empress?
We three wear the masks of House Valmont.
They signify that we are public faces of the Empress.
They are also extremely fashionable.
I'm always honored to hear from Her Majesty.
Oh. She is the honored one, Inquisitor.
Empress Celine is eager to assist the Herald of Andraste in her holy endeavor.
She will pledge her full support to the Inquisition as soon as the usurper Gaspar is defeated.
That's a generous offer.
The Empress believes wholeheartedly that the Inquisition is our best hope for peace in these difficult times.
She looks forward to cementing a formal alliance.
As soon as Gaspar is out of the way.
But we have taken enough of your time.
Please, enjoy the masquerade, Inquisitor.
This is all so familiar. I half expect my mother to materialize from the crowd and criticize my manners.
Is this how the elite of Deventer carry on?
You could almost mistake this for a soiree in the Imperium. The same double-dealing, elegant poison canapes. It's lacking only a few sacrificial slaves and some blood magic. But the knight is still young.
Have you seen anything I should know about?
Other than an overabundance of lavender perfume, No, nothing extraordinary.
What if your mother were actually here? Where would we be then?
Short one mage after he's dragged out by his earlobe.
I'm having difficulty picturing that.
Picture me a young boy of 5 years, then. She certainly always has.
I appreciate that you were willing to come here.
And expose myself to all this exquisite finery and exotic wines? Such hardship.
Not everyone's likely to be friendly. That's all I meant.
It's true. You'd think I smelled of cabbages the way they wrinkle their noses. It's of no concern, but thank you.
Well, well. What have we here? The leader of the new Inquisition. Fabled herald of the faith. Delivered from the grasp of the Fade by the hand of blessed Andraste herself. What could bring such an exalted creature here to the Imperial Court, I wonder? Do even you know?
We may never know. Courtly intrigues and all that.
Such intrigues obscure much, but not all. I am Morrigan. Some call me advisor to Empress Selene on matters of the Arcane. You have been very busy this evening, hunting in every dark corner of the palace. Perhaps you and I hunt the same prey.
I hope so. I could use another ally here.
A sentiment I share, considering recent events.
Recent events?
Recently I found and killed an unwelcome guest within these very halls. An agent of Tevinter. So I offer you this, Inquisitor. A key found on the Tevinter's body. Where it leads, I cannot say. Yet, if Selene is in danger, I cannot leave her side long enough to search. You can.
You left Selene alone? Is that wise?
I must return to her anon, but she is safe enough, for the moment. 'Twould be a great fool who strikes at her in public in front of all her court and the Imperial Guard.
What's your interest in protecting Empress Selene? Are you her bodyguard?
Do I seem a bodyguard to you? If anything were to happen to Selene, eyes would turn first to her occult advisor, even if they knew otherwise. There are sharks in the water, and I will not fall prey to them. Not now, not ever.
Why did you kill the agent? He might have had useful information.
I would not have slain the man on sight had he not attacked me first. Why? Undoubtedly, I caught him in an illicit act. I did not know from whence he came until after the battle, and regret only that I could not capture him alive. What intentions the Imperium has here, I suspect you know far better than I.
If you truly want answers, help me find them.
I already told you. I must return to protect the Empress. Proceed with caution, Inquisitor. Enemies abound, and not all of them aligned with Tevinter. What comes next will be most exciting.
This was no servant. What was he doing here? Is that Gaspard's family crest on the hilt of that dagger? Time to have a word with the Duke.
No! No!
Fancy meeting you here. Inquisitor Trevelyan. What a surprise. My report said you were terribly boring. We haven't been properly introduced, have we? I'm Ambassador Briala.
I'm glad to meet you finally, Ambassador.
Your reputation for getting results is well deserved. You cleaned this place out. It will take a month to get all the Tevinter blood off the marble. I came down to save or avenge my missing people. But you've beaten me to it. So, the Council of Errol's emissary in the courtyard. That's not your work, is it?
He was dead when I arrived.
I expected as much. You may have arrived with the Grand Duke, but you don't seem to be doing his dirty work. I knew he was smuggling his chevaliers, but killing a council emissary? Bringing Tevinter assassins into the palace? Those are desperate acts. Gaspar must be planning to strike tonight.
The Empress needs to know what's going on.
You can try to warn her. She won't believe anything from me. I misjudged you, Inquisitor. You might just be an ally worth having. What could you do with an army of elven spies at your disposal? You should think about it.
I would consider such an alliance.
We can help each other, Inquisitor. We are both outsiders here, after all. I know which way the wind is blowing. I'd bet coin that you'll be part of the peace talks before the night is over. And if you happen to lean a little bit our way, it could prove advantageous to us both. Just a thought.
We met briefly. I am Grand Duchess Floriane de Chalon. Welcome to my party.
Is there something I can do for you, Your Grace?
Indeed you can. I believe tonight you and I are both concerned by the actions of a certain person. Come, dance with me. Spies will not hear us on the dance floor.
Very well. Shall we dance, Your Grace?
I'd be delighted. You are from the Free Marches, are you not? How much do you know about our little war?
What do you think I ought to know?
My brother and my dear cousin have been at each other's throats for too long. It took great effort to arrange tonight's negotiations. Yet one party would use this occasion for blackest treason. The security of the Empire is at stake. Neither one of us wishes to see it fall.
Do we both want that, Lady Floriane?
I hope we are of one mind on this.
In times like these, it's hard to tell friend from foe. Is it not, Your Grace?
I know you arrived here as a guest of my brother, Gaspar, and have been everywhere in the palace. You are a curiosity to many, Inquisitor, and a matter of concern to some.
Am I the curiosity or the concern to you, Your Grace?
A little of both, actually. This evening is of great importance, Inquisitor. I wonder what role you will play in it. Do you even yet know who is friend and who is foe? Who in the court can be trusted?
An excellent question. I might ask the same of you, Your Grace.
In the Winter Palace, everyone is alone. It cannot have escaped your notice that certain parties are engaged in dangerous machinations tonight.
I thought dangerous machinations were the national sport in Orlais.
You have little time. The attack will come soon. You must stop Gaspar before he strikes. In the Royal Wing Garden, you will find the captain of my brother's mercenaries. He knows all Gaspar's secrets. I'm sure you can persuade him to be forthcoming.
We'll see what the night has in store, won't we?
We should take you dancing more often.
I'd happily do more dancing. Just not with Corypheus.
I promise not to invite him to your next ball.
Were you dancing with Duchess Floriane?
More importantly, what happened in the servants' quarters? I heard there was fighting.
I hope you have good news. It appears the peace talks are crumbling.
The Grand Duchess told me there's proof Gaspard is in league with Tevinter.
She offered up her own brother? She's more cutthroat than I realized.
Then, the attack on the Empress will happen tonight.
Warning Celine is pointless. She needs these talks to succeed, and to flee would admit defeat.
Then perhaps we should let her die.
I won't stand by and let her die.
Listen to me carefully, Inquisitor. What Corypheus wants is chaos. Even with Celine alive, that could still happen. To foil his plan, the Empire must remain strong. This evening, someone must emerge victorious.
And it doesn't need to be Celine. She's right.
Do you realize what you're suggesting, Leliana?
Sometimes the best path is not the easiest one.
I can't decide this. Not yet.
You must. Even inaction is a decision, Inquisitor.
You could speak to Celine in the ballroom, but she won't act. Not without proof.
If Gaspard is guilty, he'll admit nothing. If he's innocent, he knows nothing. We need the truth.
What did Duchess Florian tell you?
She said Gaspard's mercenary captain is in the royal wing, that he knows about the assassination.
Which could be a trap.
Or a lead. Either way, you should search the private quarters in that wing for clues.
Then get me access. And in the meantime, get your soldiers into position.
At once. Be careful, Inquisitor.
Are you all right?
I don't think I'm hurt. No one's supposed to be here. Briala said... Oh, I shouldn't have trusted her.
Briala told you to come to this wing of the palace?
Not personally. The ambassador can't be seen talking to the servants. We get coded messages at certain locations, but the order came from her. She's been watching the Grand Duke all night. No surprise she wanted someone to search his sister's room.
Is there anyone else who knows the code and the drop location who could have written those orders?
I don't know. Any of us could do it, but... No. No one else would send me here. It had to be Briala.
So this room belongs to the Grand Duchess Florian.
It used to. This had been her private room in Halam Shiral since she was a child. But this part of the palace was damaged, and the royal family moved to the guest wing.
What were you trying to find in Florian's old room?
The message didn't say. I should have known it was a setup.
This wing is sealed. How did you get in here?
Easy. The door was unlocked. One of the others probably handled it.
It takes great courage to come to the royal wing unarmed.
It's not courage to blindly follow Briala's orders into a trap. I knew her. Before. When she was Celine's pet. Now she wants to play revolution. But I remember. She was sleeping with the Empress who purged our alienage.
Would you be willing to testify to that, if I asked?
Absolutely. If the Inquisition will protect me, I'll tell you everything I know about our ambassador.
Most Orlesians would say that's Celine's scandal, not Briala's.
Go to the ballroom. Find Commander Cullen. He'll keep you safe.
Thank you. Make her protect you, Inquisitor.
What happened?
It's not what it looks like. Honestly, I would have preferred it if it were what it looks like. The Empress led me to believe I would be rewarded for betraying the Grand Duke. This was not what I hoped for.
I can imagine what you thought your reward would be.
Please, I beg you, don't tell Gaspard. The Empress beguiled me into giving her information about plans for troop movements in the palace tonight. She knows everything. Everything. The Duke's surprise attack has been countered before it ever began. She's turned it into a trap. The moment he strikes, she'll have him arrested for treason.
Classic, honeypot.
I don't know which is worse, Celine for using such a tactic or him for falling for it.
Oh, Orlesians.
I'll protect you from Gaspard if you're willing to testify about Celine's trap.
I'll do anything. Anything.
Inquisitor, what a pleasure. I wasn't certain you'd attend. You're such a challenge to read. I had no idea if you'd taken my bait.
I fear I'm a bit busy at the moment, if you're looking for a dance partner.
Yes, I see that. Such a pity you did not save one final dance for me. It was kind of you to walk into my trap so willingly. I was so tired of your meddling. Corypheus insisted that the Empress die tonight, and I would hate to disappoint him.
Why kill the Empress? What does Corypheus want to achieve?
Celine's death is a stepping stone on the path to a better world. Corypheus will enter the Black City and claim the godhood waiting for him. We will cast down your useless maker and usher in a united world, guided by the hand of an attentive god.
You're Orlesian royalty. Why would you help Corypheus attack your empire?
You think so small, Inquisitor. Why settle for an empire when Corypheus will remake the entire world? I admit, I will relish the look on Gaspard's face when he realizes I've outplayed him. He always was a sore loser.
What exactly is in this for you?
The world, of course. I'll deliver the entire south of Thedas, and Corypheus will save me. When he has ascended to godhood, I will rule all Thedas in his name.
You don't have to go through with this, Florian. There's still time to turn back.
Oh, my dear Inquisitor, you are so naive. In their darkest dreams, no one imagines I would assassinate Celine myself. All I need is to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. A pity you'll miss the rest of the ball, Inquisitor. They'll be talking of it for years. Kill her. Bring me the marked hand as proof. It will make a fine gift for the master.
Just his tits. What was all that? Were those demons? There aren't any more of those blasted demons coming, right?
No more demons. It's safe.
Maker? I've never seen one that close before. I knew Gaspard was a bastard, but I didn't think he'd feed me to fucking horrors over a damn bill.
Duke Gaspard lured you out here?
Well, his sister. But it had to come from him, didn't it? And all that garbage she was spewing doesn't mean anything. Gaspard had to be the mastermind.
Your accent sounds Ferelden. I thought you were one of Gaspard's mercenaries.
Born and raised in Denerim. Seems like I should have stayed there. The Duke wanted to move on the palace tonight, but he didn't have enough fancy chevaliers. So he hired me and my men. He had to offer us triple our usual pay to come to Orlais. Stinking. Fancy cheesemongers.
Want a new job? One that pays better? The Inquisition can always use a good mercenary company.
You hiring? I'm game. Anything's better than this bullshit. You want me to talk to the Empress, or the court, or sing a blasted song in a chantry? I'll do it.
Maker, you're back. The Empress will begin her speech soon. What should we do?
Wait here, Cullen. I'm going to have a word with the Grand Duchess.
What? There's no time. The Empress will begin her speech any moment.
We owe the court one more show, Your Grace.
Inquisitor.
The eyes of every noble in the Empire are upon us, Your Grace. Remember to smile. This is your party. You wouldn't want them to think you had lost control.
Who would not be delighted to speak with you, Inquisitor?
I seem to recall you saying all I needed was to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. When your archers failed to kill me in the garden, I feared you wouldn't save me this last dance. It's so easy to lose your good graces. You even framed your brother for the murder of a council emissary. It was an ambitious plan. Celine, Gaspard, the entire council of heralds, all your enemies under one roof.
This is very entertaining, but you do not imagine anyone believes your wild stories.
That will be a matter for a judge to decide, cousin.
Gaspard? You cannot believe this. You know I would never... Gaspard?
You lost this fight ages ago, Your Grace. You're just the last to find out. Your Imperial Majesty, I think we should speak in private, elsewhere.
Your sister attempted regicide in front of the entire court, Gaspard.
You're the spymaster. If anyone knew this atrocity was coming, it was you.
You don't deny your involvement.
I do deny it. I knew nothing of Florian's plans. But you... you knew it all and did nothing.
I don't know which is better. That you think I'm all-seeing, or that you're trying so hard to play innocent, and failing.
Enough! We will not bicker while Tevinter plots against our nation. For the safety of the Empire, I will have answers.
Every one of you is implicated. You all conspired to allow this to happen.
That's a bold claim, Inquisitor. Are you prepared to defend it?
You allowed the Grand Duke to sneak soldiers in, hoping he'd make a politically foolish move.
That's duplicitous, even for you, Celine.
You took the bait. I met your mercenary captain, Your Grace. He says you are ready to attack tonight.
Clever move, if you were trying to get hanged for treason.
And Briallo was playing both of you. She murdered your ambassadors and sent you each forged letters.
Even if I did... you can't touch me.
No one will defend you once it's revealed that you and Celine were lovers when she burned Halam Shiral's alienage.
You've made your point. What do you want?
You are three of the best minds in the Empire. You could do so much for Orlais and your people if you stopped fighting.
It is remarkably optimistic to believe that the three of us could ever forget our differences, Inquisitor.
I cannot believe you want to make a speech. This is foolish.
We have no choice. The nobility requires an answer for what happened.
Unless you want to pretend the war was all a dream. That would go over well. No more dithering. We make the cut swift and clean. Kindest to all of us.
Lords and ladies of the court, we are pleased to announce that an accord has been reached. Our cousin Gaspard will now hold a place of honor in our cabinet.
Friends, we assembled are the leaders of the Empire. We must set the example for all Thedas. We cannot be at war with each other, while the Fade itself challenges our borders.
We must stand united, or surely we will fall alone.
We will save Thedas from calamity, but only together may we accomplish this.
We will heal our wounded country. A long road of reconstruction lies before us. But tonight, we celebrate the arrival of peace.
Let the festivities commence!
The Orlesian nobility make drunken toasts to your victory, and yet you are not present to hear them. Do you tire so quickly of their congratulations, Inquisitor? 'Tis most fickle, after all your efforts on their behalf.
I would have stayed, but the punch ran dry. Scandalous.
Indeed. Let us see if you take this piece of news as poorly. By Imperial decree, I have been named liaison to the Inquisition. Celine wishes to offer you any and all aid, including mine. Congratulations.
I had no idea you were interested in joining the Inquisition.
The assignment has been given to me, regardless of my personal interest. Celine knows you face an opponent who wields great magical power, which is far more important than her own curiosity. You will require my knowledge if you are to defeat such magic. Regardless, Corypheus is a threat to Orlais and to myself. Thus, I am not opposed to the appointment.
What skills do you have that would benefit us?
I have knowledge which falls beyond the realm of most mages. I suspect this is also true of Corypheus, thus it behooves you to add to your arcane arsenal, yes? Mundane knowledge will not bring the rift in the sky to a close, after all.
When you say knowledge beyond the realm of most mages, do you mean blood magic?
I know many obscure, forgotten, and forbidden arts. Some of it you might consider blood magic, yes? Should thought of that frighten you, allow me to offer reassurance. Knowledge alone does no harm. What I possess, I place at your disposal to make use of or ignore as you desire.
Welcome to the Inquisition, Morrigan.
A most gracious response. I shall meet you at Skyhold.
There you are. Everyone's been looking for you. Things have calmed down for the moment. Are you all right?
I'm just worn out. Tonight has been very long.
For all of us. I'm glad it's over. I know it's foolish, but I was worried for you tonight. I may never have another chance like this, so I must ask. May I have this dance, my lady?
Of course. I thought you didn't dance.
For you, I'll try.
The matter is urgent, Lady Josephine.
I am well aware of that, revered mother.
We will need them to return to Valroyo as soon as possible. There are ceremonies, ordinations. Make us mercy.
That's quite impossible at the moment. However, I will see to this matter as soon as possible.
My Lady Inquisitor, please, may I have a word with you?
Just when you've solved one crisis, another springs up to take its place.
I am sorry to place this burden on your shoulders, but you are the only one who can help. With the political turmoil put to rest, our minds turn to a single question. The next divine. We cannot answer it without the left and right hands of divine Justinia V.
I have already told you, revered mother. Lady Leliana and Sikar Cassandra cannot be spared from their duties.
But surely with the support of the Empire, the Inquisition will not be harmed by the loss of just two souls.
Why do you need Leliana and Cassandra?
They were Her Holiness's most trusted advisors. They represent her legacy, her hopes for peace in Thedas. They could rally the Grand Clerics to follow as no candidate from the clergy has been able to.
Leliana and Cassandra, our candidates to become the Divine? How is that possible?
Not yet. But they could be. We need them to be. There is precedent. Other times when clerics remained deadlocked, a successor was chosen from outside the clergy. Lady Liliana and Seeker Cassandra were Justinia's most trusted friends and advisors. Our late Divine is still held in high esteem. To honor her, the Grand Clerics might support one of them as successor.
How long does the Chantry need them?
Several months, at least. If one of them is crowned Divine, she would not be returning to the Inquisition.
Liliana and Cassandra would have to make that decision for themselves.
And they certainly will, at a later date. The Inquisitor has only just returned and has important business to attend to. You must excuse us, revered mother. Don't let them detract from your victory at Alamshiral. The support of the Empire should make our search for the Grey Wardens easier. Varric is eager to help his friend Hawke.
I'd be perfectly happy never again setting foot in the Winter Palace. It wasn't the gossip and backstabbing, I know what the game entails, but the indifference to it all.
At least there was dancing.
Or an attempt at it, anyway.
I thought you did well.
Well, I'm grateful for your poor taste in dance partners.
That's all for now.
Another time, then.
Will you not consider it, Lady Cassandra? The clerics are still sequestered. If no one steps forward, they will debate until...
And you think I could make them agree? I've heard enough for one day, Mother Giselle.
Talk to her, Your Worship.
The fun never ends in Skyhold, does it?
The Inquisitor was hilarious. That's what they'll say one day, you watch. I assume you've heard that Liliana and I are both candidates to be the next Divine. Because of what happened at Alamshiral, of course, the Empire favors you, thus everyone close to you. So now the Chantry bandies our names about without even asking us first.
How can you and Liliana be candidates? You're not even priests.
It's not without precedent. Amar III was sister to the Emperor, and Galatea a commoner. Liliana and I were, at least, part of the Chantry hierarchy. It would be accepted.
I think you'd make an excellent Divine.
Truly? I never look good in hats. Surely it was never meant to be like this. The Chantry, the Circle of Magi, the Templars... This cannot be what they intended when it all began. The Chantry should provide faith, hope. Instead, it cannot veer from its course, even in the face of certain death.
I'm surprised to hear you, of all people, say that.
Oh? Am I not the same woman who declared the Inquisition against the Chantry's wishes? In all my years as a Seeker, I did what I was told. My faith demanded it. But now my faith demands something else, that I see with better eyes.
You're concerned, then make it better.
Did you know Varric is Andrastian? Oh, he blasphemes with every second breath, but deep down he believes. His heart is virtuous. But he would never step foot in a chantry. It should be the first place to which the virtuous turn. It needs to change. Perhaps I must be the one to change it.
You're not the only candidate. What about Liliana?
Liliana says she wishes to follow Justinia's legacy, but she and I remember a different person. Justinia knew her fellow clerics and the people would only accept so much change. Liliana would cast it all aside and start over, I think, and that would be chaos for us all.
What would you change about the chantry?
The Circle of Magi has its place, but it needs reform. Let the mages govern themselves with our help. Let the Templars stand not as the jailers of mages, but as protectors of the innocent. We must be vigilant, but we must also be compassionate to all peoples of Thedas, human or no. That is what I would change.
So this is your new crusade?
I've agreed to nothing yet.
And if the chantry calls on you?
Then I will do whatever I can, for as long as I can. I suppose I should not be so concerned. The clerics speak my name for now, nothing more. For now, restoring order and stopping Corypheus remain our priority.
It's true. Some look to Cassandra or even me as Justinia's successor. I never thought the idea would gain momentum. Of course, with the other candidates out of the picture...
Is becoming divine something you really want?
When Justinia was alive, I would have laughed at anyone who even suggested that I could be her successor. Things have changed. Still, I don't know. Restoring the chantry will be like trying to steer a sinking vessel through a storm.
Whoever becomes divine will have my support if she requires it.
And I'm sure whoever becomes divine will absolutely require the Inquisition's backing. The chantry is faltering, but it still has influence over the people. Who tells the people what's right? Who do they look to in times of peril? A divine with enough support can change the chantry. And with it, Thedas. But this is a discussion for later. If Corypheus wins, finding a new divine will be the least of our problems.
Have a thing for strapping young Templars, I see.
What's this about?
Oh, nothing. Just something I find rather adorable about you. Marvelous business, the Winter Palace. You saved an empress, and now she's eating out of your hand. Perfect mental image. All this dancing, politics, and murder... makes me a bit homesick.
Happy to oblige. The taste of home. Just for you.
Not just for me. Fun for the whole family.
Perhaps I should have invited some.
We were there. That's what counts.
I hope you tried the ham they were serving, by the way. Tasted of despair. It's fascinating.
I should go.
You know where I'll be.
You're the Inquisitor. Mother never told me the Inquisitor was a mage.
If you can sense magic, don't ever become a Templar.
I can't. The lyrium gives me terrible nightmares.
Kieran, are you bothering the Inquisitor?
Of course not. Did you see what's on her hand, Mother?
I did see. 'Tis time to return to your studies, little man. My son. Never where you expect him to be, naturally.
I didn't know you had a son.
Why would you? I take great pains to not let my own reputation affect him in any way. To most in the Imperial Court, he's simply a quiet and well-spoken lad, perhaps the heir of some distant family. But he goes where I go. Worry not, Inquisitor. Kieran is a curious boy, but seldom troublesome.
Will his father be joining us as well?
I have raised Kieran on my own for quite some time now, as was my preference from the start. So, 'tis but the two of us, Inquisitor. Your fortress is a large place, and you will scarce notice our presence.
He seems like a fine young man.
But not the sort one might expect a woman like me to raise. No son of mine would be raised in a marsh, bereft of contact with the outside world. His future will be difficult enough without my adding to his burden. To think, until recently, this place stood decrepit, occupied only by the desperate and the lost. Now it is party to events that threaten to shake the world. I wonder if it is pleased.
It sounds like you've heard of Skyhold before.
This fortress was built upon the remains of a site holy to the ancient elves. They called it Tarasalan, the place where the sky is kept. It is said that from here, they reached up to the heavens to bring them down to rest. They abandoned it, as did the humans who came after them. Bones laid upon bones, silent until your arrival.
I like this place. I've made it mine.
The magic in this place has seeped into the stones, protecting it from darkness. Those who let it fall to ruin did not know what they possessed. You, I think, shall do it justice. You were kind to welcome my aid, Inquisitor, even knowing as little of me as you do. I will do my best to aid your cause with all the knowledge at my disposal. This I swear to you.
I appreciate whatever help you can give us.
Some might think Corypheus a madman for seeking godhood. Yet one must ask, what were the old gods? What secrets of theirs did the ancient magisters know? What I fear, what all should fear, is not that Corypheus believes he can succeed. 'Tis that he actually may.
I do not believe a reminder is necessary for this accused. Her capture and disgrace could not have been more public. Grand Duchess Floriane de Chalon, although her titles are among the dignities already at risk of forfeiture. You spared her life despite her treachery. What becomes of it now falls to you.
The consequences of our dance continue to echo, Lady Floriane.
Despite her posture, Lady Floriane has acknowledged your authority.
Should I curse you on behalf of the Elder One? I realize he had no intention of honoring the concordats I manipulated. Do as you must. I respect your mastery of the game, even as I despise your victory. Celine does not know her fortune.
She has caused no end of misery. It's time she brought some joy. Grand Duchess Floriane de Chalon, jester to the Inquisition. In flat shoes.
History's greatest malevolence, Inquisitor. I am the jest of Orlais already.
Were you waiting for me?
Yes. I mean, no.
I can come back later if you prefer.
No. Please stay. We have some dealings in Ferelden. I was hoping you might accompany me. When you can spare the time, of course.
Is something wrong?
What? No. I would rather explain there, if you wish to go.
I believe there's time now.
I will make the necessary arrangements.
Where are we?
You walk into danger every day. I wanted to take you away from that, if only for a moment. I grew up not far from here. This place was always quiet.
Did you come here often?
I loved my siblings, but they were very loud. I would come here to clear my head. Of course, they always found me eventually.
You were happy here.
I was. I still am.
Alone with the mage. That doesn't concern you?
The Templars have rules on fraternization, but I'm no longer bound by them.
I know, but you've seen the worst mages have to offer. How can you not see that in me?
I don't. If I've given you reason to doubt, whatever I fear of magic, I see none of that in you. The last time I was here was the day I left for Templar training. My brother gave me this. It just happened to be in his pocket, but he said it was for luck. Templars are not supposed to carry such things. Our faith should see us through.
You broke the Order's rule. I'm shocked.
Until a year ago, I was very good at following them. Most of the time. This was the only thing I took from Ferelden that the Templars didn't give me. Humor me. We don't know what you'll face before the end. This can't hurt.
I'll keep it safe.
Good. I know it's foolish, but I'm glad.
May I ask you something?
Always.
You've mentioned siblings. With everything that's happening, do you know if they're all right?
I've received word from my eldest sister. She was always good at tracking me down. South Reach has experienced the same chaos as everywhere else. My family is fine. Pray they remain so.
Your sister tracked you down? She didn't know where you were?
I let her know I was in Haven. She assumed I survived. It's not the first time. I may have neglected to tell her when I was transferred to Kirkwall.
Why?
I wasn't in a good state. I wanted only to leave. I received an angry letter about my disappearance 2 years later. For all her reprimands, it was a relief to hear from someone who knew me before the Blight.
The Inquisition won't last forever. What will you do when this is over?
To be honest, I hadn't given it much thought until recently. I'm not used to having so many possibilities.
That's all I wanted to know.
I'm sure you have other matters to attend.
Is this a bad time? I can come back.
No, it's all right. Bills are really not that engrossing. I've been meaning to come talk to you anyhow. I never officially joined the Inquisition. I don't know how to do this disciplehood thing. I'm a businessman. Never really followed a chosen one before.
I don't need a disciple. I need a friend.
If you knew how intimidating you are, you wouldn't make it sound so simple. You just don't know what you are to the people out there. The Herald of Andraste is a symbol bigger than any of us.
What am I to you, then?
None of this shit makes any sense to me. Is this the end of the world? Did Andraste send you through the breach? I have no idea. You heard the crowd singing after Haven was attacked?
Whatever I am to Thedas, I'm still just an ordinary person.
So, just a regular person, like anybody else. Right. I should probably get back to work, unless... You up for a game of Wicked Grace?